Welcome to Theo Trade. This is Don Kaufman. January 20th, 2021, an absolutely ripping rally in today's trading session, led by none other than tech. But I got to ask the question here, is this buy the election, possibly sell the inauguration? We're going to look at a couple of things in detail outside the fact that, yeah, the S&Ps are up 62 handles with just about 12 minutes left inside of the trading session, but it's all about the monsters of tech. It's not even so much about the NASDAQ. When I talk about the monsters of tech, yeah, we're back to this rotation where we're looking at none other than Microsoft, Apple, Netflix, right? Facebook, Amazon, Google. Of course, Netflix is coming off of its earnings announcement, which is a three sigma move. You know, Netflix was looking like it was going to have about a $35 move. Here we are actually facing upwards of $90 plus, and it's actually off some of the highs of the session. Let's get to work and actually evaluate a little bit about the marketplace. And I'm going to tell you specifically here momentarily of why I'm kind of questioning if this is a buy the election and sell the inauguration. In fact, let's get to that business first and foremost. There's a few things that absolutely are standouts inside of today's trading session. One of them, which is the fact that the financials did not participate in any of the upside. In fact, the financials are going to close the day largely unchanged. And to get really specific, you know, Goldman Sachs is actually down by the tune of about 1%. Looking down the list, some of the usual suspects, Bank of America off by the tune of 1.2%, JP Morgan off about 1.4%, and it goes on and on. Morgan Stanley actually had numbers today. They were stellar, just stellar earnings report. Stocks actually flat, okay, coming into today's close. So this is one of the areas that has been pivotal to driving the S&P 500 higher. And I've said time and again, the S&Ps can actually stage a little bit of a rally, but they're going to need the help from those financial in the days to come to not only sustain it, but to continue any of the rally. The other area, okay, that's really questionable happens to be none other than the bond market. The bond market looks like it's actually poised to make a move back to the upside. Now, today's bond trade has been, you know, less than stellar. Whatever, it's seven ticks. You know, the notes here are up what? You know, maybe a point, you know, or you know what, 1.5 ticks. Negligible move in terms of the bond markets. But right there, I'm questioning, are the bond markets in a guarded state because they might see some risk coming? Are the financials, all right, simply just down because the bonds are up? The other perplexing area happens to be none other than the US dollar. The dollar, okay, it's flat. Let's not make a big deal about it. It's flat. But with this kind of explosive move inside of the marketplace, I'd anticipate maybe the dollar was coming back off, especially with some of the fiscal stimulus, shall we say, being announced today. All right, switching gears a little bit here. Let's actually cruise over to the SPX because the move that we're seeing today, which is right now, again, some 57 handles, no one should be surprised in any way, shape, or form, okay, of the move itself. And the reason I say that is if you're taking a look at the SPX, okay, and we mentioned this kind of incessantly on the weekend video, and we mentioned this almost every one of these nightly videos that we do, okay, always be watching the expected move, right? Now I'm going to take you from a daily chart and the expected move. And for those of you that are not necessarily up to speed on the expected move this week was just north of $80. Let's call it $82. So you're looking for this move, $82 higher and or $82 lower. And that move, well, we have a four-day trading week because here we are already on Wednesday. We're halfway through the week. We're home. But to look at this on a daily chart does not do it justice. You start looking at it on an intraday chart, all we've done throughout the course of the trading session is drive to the edge of the expected move, skirt the edge of it, okay? The day is not necessarily over. But listen, the expected move and the edge of that expected move, that's this line drawn on the screen over here, is somewhere right around 3850. We're home, okay? Does it mean that we can't per se cross above that level? Absolutely, unequivocally, no. All right, listen, there's still plenty of time left in the week, and we could, like other weeks, blow through the upper edge of the expected move. But from a probability point of view, right around, again, this 3850 is just that. It's home, right? And that is where risk kind of lives. And when I say where risk lives, you know, the market-making firms, everything to them is delta, all right? And mitigating that delta and the rate of gamma. And right here on this edge of the expected move is kind of where things go a little bit more net neutral for them. So you got to think about that, you know, the 3850 level being kind of like the happy place for the marketplace. And, you know, it's an interesting irony because here we are with just minutes to go to the cash close. We kind of almost feel like we're going to pull back into it. Again, that's suspect. It doesn't necessarily have to close on the edge of the expected move. But people, when you're looking at a $3,850 product, and that product is like what, $5 off the edge of a critical hedging level, okay, you need pay attention. All right, a few other aspects I think that are also pivotal inside of this marketplace that they're, you know, causing me to actually ask a few questions over here. It's not just the bonds. It's not just the fact that the dollar is actually flat over here. The SPX did, well, what we expected it to do, okay? The other thing that really resonates in today's trading session, retail traders. And this is something we've talked just, again, incessantly about. Retail trade is very, very apparent. I mean, if you take a look at something like Microsoft, and it's Microsoft that's the real standout to me. Okay. I actually took an intraday position here, got run over a little bit. That's neither here nor there. The point that I want to make with Microsoft, okay, look at the action inside of the calls versus puts. And the Sizzle Index also speaks volumes. Okay. The calls are active. How much more active? About 2.4 times as active as they have been in the previous five trading sessions. But you can see by just looking, all right, at the traded at bid or below or traded at the ask or above, 150,000 contracts been traded at the ask or above. Listen, that just, it reeks of retail traders just going out there and doing something crazy like using market orders, and they're just buying calls, right? And the buying of calls literally will drive share price higher inside of Microsoft. So that retail trade that we kind of questioned on the weekend video is because there's no question that there's a retail options bubble, and that bubble of retail clientele is driving today some of your tech stocks higher. I mean, listen, the monsters of tech, this is this conglomerate symbol that I built. It's up to the tune of 4%. So obviously, okay, there are some big forces in play right now, but this is not about, I mean, listen, Microsoft did some 30 million shares. That's not by any stretch of the imagination huge, especially when you've traded almost 600,000 options and you realize you're going to need almost 30 million shares just to hedge out the, what, 600,000 option contracts. All right, let's again completely change tone over here. So I'm looking at the S&Ps. We're pulling back right to the edge of the expected move. No surprise there. Okay. The financials are weak. The Russell is a little bit weak, and the Russell's been the little engine that could. Volatility is backing off to a degree. I would, you know, to a larger degree, but I would have anticipated more out of the volatility futures. The volatility futures are only down 47 cents. You start looking at this, and again, be as objective as you possibly can. Take a look at the volatility futures right now, and they just rolled over to new contracts. But the volatility futures, we're still trading, okay, at relatively high levels of volatility versus, you know, previous years. And that, you know, you look at this and you're like, oh, whatever, man, we're at like a 21 VIX. Yeah, but with markets effectively at all-time highs, right? So where else is their strength coming from inside of today's marketplace? And the answer is there isn't. I mean, even stuff like Tesla today, this is just humdrum. This is just getting dragged up mildly with the rest of the marketplace. As I mentioned, stuff like Goldman Sachs isn't moving, Caterpillar's actually down. When you look at the advanced decline line, this speaks volumes. I mean, a lot of today's advanced decline line was literally 60-40. This isn't even a high correlation coefficient. Again, looking at this marketplace and be as objective as you possibly can in doing so, right? You should have a degree of fear of a market that is capable of exploding like this to the upside. It's exploding to the upside, again, predominantly because we're seeing option traders come in there and literally buy calls, and they're doing it in only a handful of products. Okay, the marketplace, the capability to move up with things like financials starting to defect. All right, guess what? They're just flat, right? Stuff like the energy sector, which has been one of the most hot sectors from the beginning of the year, totally flat today. So there is some degree of defection here. I would watch very carefully in just, the remainder of this week what the financials do, because again, this is where we believe is going to set the tone, okay, for the remainder of the market. The other aspect that I feel pretty strongly about, the volatility is down. It's not down dramatically. Any further drop in volatility, I am going to look at as an opportunity to get long things like VIX volatility spreads. That's when I go out there and sell a put spread in the VIX, turn around and buy call spreads in the VIX. I'm telling you, people, the marketplace right now feels fractured. That is why I'm actually asking that question. Is this a buy the election, sell the inauguration? Thanks everybody for joining us here at Theo Trade. Have a wonderful evening. Bye-bye.